Well, did you know that Australia and New Zealand are in the top 10 happiest countries in the world? But how happy are you? Are you just thriving or are you surviving? Well, today with us to chat about living more happy is internationally renowned forward thinker, author, public speaker and educational leader in lifestyle medicine, Dr. Darren Morton. Dr. Morton, thank you so much for joining us today. I listed off like a whole sort of credentials there for you. I'm sure there's more to add to that though.
Well, after you said that, I can hardly wait to hear what I'm about to say.
I know, me too. Let's get into this.
Yeah.
So we are in the top sort of 10 happy countries in the world, but then you read statistics like 1 in 10 Australians are taking antidepressants and in New Zealand, in the last 10 years, prescriptions for antidepressants have risen by over 60%. Mm. So is this a mismatch of information we're getting here?
Well, look, the great news is Australia is in the top 10 countries
yeah.
in terms of the happiest in the world.
Where's New Zealand,
number 10.
By the way?
Oh, I knew
New Zealand.
I knew that would come up. So, yes, and New Zealand does outrank us.
Yeah.
Two places ahead.
I know when they're colder, how could that be? But
Well, Australia comes in at number 10.
Yeah, okay, so we just
this
slip
year.
In.
We're slipping. Last year was number 9.
Oh.
But look, even that said, you're right. In Australia, we know that 1 in 10 Australian adults are taking antidepressants each day. That's doubled in the past decade.
Yeah.
And so the science seems to suggest, the statistics seem to indicate that there are probably about 20% of people that are reporting that they're truly flourishing in life. And I mean, that's fantastic. Then down the other end of the sort of mental health continuum, we probably have about 20% of people that are really struggling. Which leaves us probably 60% of people in the middle that, hey, wouldn't say they're down, but...
I wouldn't say they're happy either.
Not happy either, yeah.
Interesting.
So nature versus nurture, happiness.
Mm.
Is it just a person's nature to be happy?
Yeah, that's a great question. So the science on this is quite fascinating. It indicates that probably about half of our enduring happiness... Now, we're not talking about how happy you are right now, because you may have got fined by the police because you were speeding on the way here. But, you know, so obviously our mental health will fluctuate over the course of the day. But when we look at enduring happiness, probably 50% of that is determined by our genetics. And this is why we know, some people are naturally bubbly and, happy, and other people are a little bit more forlorn and perhaps even, sort of see the glass as half full as compared to half.
But does mental health, is it really gauged by happiness? You know, some people might just be kind of, as you were saying, level and content. And is that really the best gauge for, checking someone's mental health?
Yeah, it's a great question. So this, once again, the science, from a scientific perspective, we view happiness, and that word happy can sound a little bit trite at times, but really it's something deeper than that we're interested in. We're scientists, we call it subjective personal well-being. And it's made up of three things, essentially having positive emotion, so that's a good thing.
So what do you think of as positive emotions?
Well, joy, peace, contentment, excitement, all of those sorts of things. Not having too much negative emotion, which are, anger, guilt perhaps, and some of these emotions. But then this other really important component, which is overall satisfaction with life.
Okay, so you've written this book here, like Live More Happy, and so you've been researching this for what, like 10 to 15 years, I hear? So there's a lot of science that's gone into this.
Yeah.
So what are some of the practical ways people can sort of think about to get more happy? Because if you think about it, mums are, like young mums particularly, are in the trenches and it's a really hard, difficult time. So what are some practical ways that they can think about to get happier?
Yeah, and look, there are many, this is the key essence of my message. There are many evidence-based things that we know work to help people improve their mood and in so doing improve their life. And so, and they're coming from positive psychology, these strategies are coming from lifestyle medicine. But they're things like motion creates emotion.
So exercise.
What does that mean?
What does that mean?
What does that mean? And I know what you're gonna say here. It's that E word, isn't it?
I didn't use the E word. Because I know that most people equate exercise with pain and sweat, right? But
Yes, that's true.
As a health expert, I can tell you, you don't need to exercise. All you need to do is move. Right? We actually know that when people just move, and the more dynamically you can move, whether that's just moving in...
Fantastic. tick for the day.
We know that when people do that kind of stuff, for probably within 2 minutes, their mood lifts.
So, like taking the baby out for a quick walk...
anything, play, just move. Move your body.
So what are some of the other ones that you've got there, though?
So one of the other that goes along, and you've alluded to this, is blue and green should often be seen. And what we know is the science behind getting outside is incredibly powerful for improving people's emotional well-being.
Mm.
And I would say this to mums of kids, get them outside. kids need to get outside. Mm-hmm. We know particularly bright light in natural environments, blue and green spaces, very, very powerful.
So out to the playground, out in the backyard, down
moving
to the
dynamically,
beach,
all
put them
of
in
that's
the water.
Fantastic.
Yep.
I've sent my kids outside as a punishment before. I'm like, run to the fence and back to the tell you what, they come back happier.
I like that punishment.
I shouldn't say the word. That's not good. Some other ones.
Oh, look, there are things like food feeds your mood. We know this is very powerful. And, you know, I've moved away from telling people what they're eating incorrectly.
Oh, good. Yeah. Thank you.
I actually encourage people to eat more. Mm. And what we need to be eating more of are plant-based foods. Yeah. We know that foods that are high in fibre feed your guts, improve your gut health, and your gut is actually your second brain.
Mm.
We know that we actually know that people who consume more fruit and vegetables generally are happier. And there's a dose-response relationship here.
You know, there's one thing that you're saying that I think is encouraging for me. It's like improving your mood. Because I think there's a lot of pressure nowadays to be happy and for people to feel like if they're not quite hitting that mark of happiness that it's, you know, they're somehow not succeeding in life.
Yes.
But it sounds like you're saying improving your mood, you know, which is, you know, it's kind of another dimension of this idea of happiness. You
look,
know?
I think this is a really important point. I'm more about direction as compared to destination. Mm. Because the reality is, you know, wise Solomon once said, there is a time to laugh and there's a time to cry.
Mm.
You know, we all have these. So I'm being real about this.
We have our ups and downs.
But it's not that all of us can be glowingly happy 24/7. That's not realistic.
That's unrealistic, isn't it?
And some people portray
a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
Some people hear that message and they feel even more stressed.
Yeah.
Like,
yes.
How can I get to that point of being happy?
But while we can't do that, what we can do is on a daily basis take active steps to move up the ladder, up the emotional
so even if
ladder.
We take one rung up from
absolutely,
our happiness,
yeah.
then we're
That's
achieving.
A positive thing.
Yeah.
We know that happier people live longer, they're healthier, they're more productive.
Oh, I'm going to live for a really long time, aren't I?
They're better parents. They're better parents, you know, they're better influencers. We actually know that one of the chapters I have is called Together Feels Better. You know, and we know this. We know that we all have mirror neurons in our brain and we feed off each other. And this is why people's emotional state influences others. And this is, you know, when we're caregivers, it becomes really important that we self-care, look after ourselves so that we can be that positive influence
in
the lives
of others. Yeah, that also ties into sort of, you know, being that village. And that's what a lot of mums are always looking for, sort of being part of a village. Is that what you mean by together is better?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
And what about gratitude? Where does that come into it?
Yeah, look, and coming out of the positive psychology world, there are some fascinating things. We know that having a positive focus, a positive orientation towards the past, gratitude,
good.
Present,
there you go.
Future, hope. You know,
there are lots of ways that we can sort of be happy. Dr. Morton, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. We've actually got a few of his books to give away. So if you're interested in one, just check it out on our social media. There's a limited number, so get in while you can. Ladies, a pleasure as always. Loved your company. We will see you next week. Thanks for joining us. Bye. Thank you.